Wow, this is so nice. I'm really honored to be here tonight and honored that you chose me to give this last lecture to the class of 2011. I have a lot to tell you, and it's been difficult to pick a topic. The one time I thought I should give a stunning lecture about the absolute merits of markets and the values of capitalism. But somehow I don't think that would be fitting or relevant to you right now. So I'm going to give you some perspectives and guideposts that have helped me and may help you through your life. You see, I've been where you are now, a long time ago, but you have not been where I have been. In fact, you won't be my age until the year 2060. So you would think in this period of time I've learned something, and I'm going to try and give you some of what I've learned. I have some insights, and especially about jobs, and I'll give you the best of them. I've titled this talk, From the Greenhouse to the Garden. Muhlenberg has been your greenhouse, and I've been in the garden for a long time. Those of you who know me know that I think in terms of fundamental truths, and then discuss those truths using stories about my life or what I've seen. People discuss, tell me that I'm a storyteller. The turning points in life where you move from one condition, like being a student, to something else, like having a job, are simultaneously exciting, scary, lovely, terrifying, serene, and chaotic times. That's where you are now, so much is happening to you. So sit back, relax, and listen to one of your older friends, me. In all of this job stuff, I can think of at least four truths. Actually, I had a lot more, but I've pared it down to four. Truth number one, I have students come and tell me they don't know that they know anything. Well, truth number one is that you know a lot more than you think you know. And you have to have faith in yourself, and you will need that faith, especially during these turning points in your life. You know more than you think you know. Truth number two, your mind cannot analyze or comprehend all that happens to you or around you, but your inner spirit somehow puts it together. You have to listen to that inner spirit, which some people call a gut feeling or a gut instinct or whatever. Truth number three, you will get a lot more out of life if you are willing to occasionally step outside your comfort zone, even if it's hard to do so. And number four is, things will happen to you that you cannot control. So you have to acknowledge that you don't have as much control as you'd like, and you have to focus on the things you can control. I know the jobs are on your mind, even if you have one, and especially if you don't yet have a job. Some of you are going to graduate school, so that takes care of the job issue for a bit, but it will crop up later. So let's talk about life and use jobs as a focus. I've had several very different jobs, and leaving one job and going to another is something I will always remember in great detail. So here's my first story. I was a barber before college, and I married while I was still a full-time undergraduate student at Penn State. My wife worked at Penn State, but our first child came earlier than we planned, and I needed a job. I interviewed with the Ordnance Research Lab at Penn State for a mathematical aid position. And in that interview, I was rather liberal in answering their questions. When they asked if I had any experience with Fourier series, for example, I said yes. And in fact, I said yes to everything they asked. The only problem was I really didn't have those experiences or that knowledge. And by the end of the interview, I was certain I would not get the job, certain they must have known I was stretching the truth. But I still needed a job. So I talked with a barber in State College and planned to step out of school and hoped that somehow I would get back to school to finish my last two semesters. As I was walking out of our apartment with my tools to start the barbering job, the mailman was there, and he gave me a letter offering me that job at Penn State. I took my tools back into the apartment, walked to the lab to accept the job before they took back the offer. This was a massive turning point for me. In the next 6 years, I learned so much. I mastered those topics that I had fibbed about. Fourier series and I became good friends, and I accomplished things I could not have imagined I could have done. Whatever caused the lab to decide to hire me was clearly out of my control. And when I took the job, I somehow had faith I could master those topics. Those of you know me know that I am not an overly self-confident fellow. I can tell you to have faith in yourself, but I often have trouble applying that principle to myself, even though I have had repeated instances indicating that I really do know much more than I think I know. Later in my life, when I worked at Virginia Power, I was an expert witness, and I would sit alone in a witness stand testifying about some economic issue with big financial implications for my employer. Lots of pressure from opposing lawyers asking questions to dispel my testimony. I was often astonished by the intelligent answers that came out of my mouth. I would at times be surprised at what I was able to do under that pressure. Sometimes I would listen and say, "That was really sharp. Where did that come from?" So listen to me carefully, and I'm talking to myself as well now as well as you. You know a lot more than you think you know. What that means is you can take a chance and step beyond those fears. I moved through Penn State researching and teaching on both the main campus and the Beaver campus in computer science and mathematics for the next 19 years. I was tenured in mathematics in the early 1970s, and I had a lot of wonderful experiences there. I grew very comfortable with Penn State. Let me take a moment to talk about this comfort zone stuff. The Muhlenberg bubble is a real comfort zone, and some of you have told me you'd like to stay here a bit longer. We spend a lot of time in our comfort zones doing what feels calm and reassuring. But every once in a while, you will find a need to step outside that comfort zone, and it's important that you make these steps. For me, these self-induced changes from doing what I knew how to do without thinking and living and working in a totally different place have been exciting and scary moments. They were also the most momentous times in my life. One of the great mysteries I have observed and cannot comprehend is those people who go to work every day and hate what they do. I've seen them in the academic and in the corporate world. Even if they are only mid-age, they speak of retirement as if that retirement will save them from doing what they are doing now. Now, if we lived in the Middle Ages, when people had few choices, I could understand it, but not in the 21st century. If there's anything to be gained by living now, it's the abundance of choice. And by graduating from Muhlenberg College, you have increased the choices in your life. That doesn't mean that making these choices is easy. Sometimes it's very hard. I know how it is to have a bad day or a bad month, but when the bad feelings get into your soul, you know it's time to make a change. In the late 1970s, second story, I began to lose my enthusiasm for teaching, and I started to gripe about everything. My spirit started to sag, and then it became worse. I didn't like to be a griper, but all of a sudden, I could see things around me that I didn't like, and they were bothering me, and they never did before. I really never knew why this happened, but it did happen, and I couldn't stand it. I knew that if I stayed at Penn State, I would be one of those who would say I hate my job or complain endlessly about what is going on. So I decided to leave and do something entirely different. Some of my friends thought I was nuts leaving a tenured position with many years of service, but my spirit said, do something else and get excited again. This move was really complicated. I was now the father of 6 children, and whatever decision I made for me would have an effect on my family. Children are rarely ready to leave their comfort zone. You'll find that out when you have children. But through lots of family discussions, they agreed, you know, that's in quotes, to leave Pennsylvania. And the rope marks eventually left their bodies. I left Penn State, hired on with Virginia Power in Richmond in June 1980 as senior economist. I moved from the academic teaching world into the corporate sphere, a huge change in my work life. This was a poor time to make a move because it was the beginning of the long economic recession in the 1980s. My children ranged from 2 to 19 years old. My wife didn't work outside the home, and I took a $2,000 pay cut. about an 8% cut in pay. This was scary to say the least. I can remember sitting in Virginia asking myself, what did you do? You don't know anything about this job, and you knew everything about your old job. Looking back on this decision, I am amazed at this choice. But my spirit wasn't whispering to me, it was screaming. And that's why I left Penn State. It was the best professional thing I've ever done. My enthusiasm returned, and my performance eventually promoted me to chief economist at one of the largest electric utilities in the world. I was also an economic advisor to four Virginia governors, and I had a great time, more than I could ever describe. And I have never said, and I will never say, I hate this job. I look at those who complain all the time, and I feel sorry for them. They stayed too long at something that did not excite or enthuse them. But if you take my advice, take advantage of this time in which we live, and the abundance of choices you have now. Step outside of that comfort zone when you get that sagging feeling, and you will recognize it right away. And take charge of your life. If you don't, the consequences are staggering to you and to everyone around you. Finally, you may ask, how did I come here? How did I end up coming to Muhlenberg? Well, the answer is simple. I was the chief economist for Virginia Power, living alone in Richmond and raising my last daughter, Lizzie. I remember the comfort I felt doing my job and raising my daughter. I would not have thought that anything was missing from my life. But to make a long story short, and this is a lovely, wonderful story that many of you know, because I've told it enough, I fell in love with Kathy Price, who was my counterpart at PPL, the electric utility down the street here in Allentown. We decided that the best option for our family was for Lizzie and me to move here. So in 1993, I began to make another transition, again in poor economic times. So I know what you're going through as you search for jobs in this jobless recovery of 2011. It's hard. I interviewed for an economics teaching position in summer of 1993 at Reading Area Community College called RAC down in Reading. After my interview, I thought I was a shoo-in. It looked like things were coming together in my job, but RAC didn't call and they didn't call. Eventually, I called them to find they hired another person. Not me. I was devastated. How could this be? I had very good credentials in Virginia, but I couldn't even get a community college teaching job up here. I was in a major funk for a while. However, this was not a bad thing. It was instead a marvelous event because I later found this job. If RAC had offered me that job, I would not be here right now, and that would have been a catastrophe for me. You are not in as much control as you think. So, enough of the stories, look at me. You know that I'm one happy fellow. I love being at Muhlenberg. I love my wife beyond anything I could have imagined. My children have grown into very good people, and I am proud of them. We have 7 grandchildren. Is that right, Kat? Sometimes I wonder how I got here. And I know that it was in large part because I followed the path of my spirit, that part of me that seems to know more than I can comprehend. I have to admit that I have not been in control of many of the events that have happened to me. My only duty, and your only duty, is to go to bed at night, and before you close your eyes, ask if you did all you could do. Ask if you left anything on the table. If the answer is, yeah, I did that, you can sleep well because that's all you can do. If not, if you wasted the day, get off your duff, because things are happening around you and you need to be ready for them. I love being in Muhlenberg, and when I came here in 1994, I thought this would be a short part of my work life. I thought by 2011 I'd be sipping a mint julep on my veranda along the 9th hole of a good golf course. But Muhlenberg has gotten into my soul. From all the wonderful friendships I've formed with you, all the time someone has held the door for me, and I have held it for others. For all the times a sneeze in class is rewarded with half the class saying, God bless you. For all the kindness and warmth we show each other. For all the good and hard work we do here, I've been proud to be part of this college. I've taken groups of Muhlenberg students to Maastricht twice and to Rome once, and these Muhlenberg traits really do put us above our counterparts. You have made this small college a truly unique place. You are ready, more ready than you can appreciate, to get out into the world and get into this next wonderful period of your life. I'm so glad you came here and that I was able to be with you, to be here with you. But the hardest part of this job is that you will not be here in the fall, and know that I will miss you. I will not say goodbye because that implies our friendship is ending, and I intend to keep these friendships forever. Instead, I'll just say I'll see you and leave it at that. If I have touched your life in any way, it cannot compare to what you have done for me. If ever you need me, I'm around. If ever I need you, I know where you are. We are friends in the long run. Well, I'm done now, except for one thing. I'm no longer Dr. Laposata to you. We are colleagues in life now, so call me by my name. It's Sam. Thank you.